Welcome back to Pinoy Crossover, the basketball show for the Filipino community. Let's talk about what's up in the NBA. Marky Mark, I want to hear your expert opinions. Which team should have made the playoffs but didn't? Let's start by, or even choose, Denver Nuggets. Talk about the Denver Nuggets. Their season fell short. Do you think they should have been in the playoffs?
I mean, they were on pace to make the playoffs, if you really think about it. They had, it was just no one expected the 6-8 position. I mean, 4-8 in the West to be so close and to be so tight. It had to come to the very last game of the season for them to find out if they're going to make. And they had to fight for it against Minnesota Timberwolves, who just got Jimmy Butler back. So it was a tough game. It went to overtime, and they fought for it. Just at the end of the game, they just couldn't really close it. But this was they could have made the playoffs if they really pushed for it. But I think injuries really affected them as well this season. They lost Millsap for the majority of the season, and they didn't really have that rhythm with him. And Jokic also suffered some injury. Gary Harris suffered some injury. So there was a lot of injury that came into play. The West was very tough, but they were a very good team, and I think next year they're going to come out better. The only thing I noticed for them was that their personnel was a little bit not defined. I mean, Jokic, they got someone like Paul Millsap, who has the same skill set as Jokic. So it was trying to find a way to build around Jokic was kind of difficult for them because they made a good pickup with Trey Lyles. I really think that Kenneth Faried, Trey Lyles were a better fit with Jokic because he's so good as a passer. He's so good at facilitating for them that they don't really need another player of the same skill set like Paul Millsap. They could have paid someone who complements Jokic and complements Gary Harris and Jamal Murray more, whereas because Paul Millsap kind of needs the ball a lot in his hand to kind of make a place and to be the kind of player that he was in Atlanta. So I think that was kind of a mistake for them. So maybe next year they're going to have the whole offseason together to kind of figure it out and maybe they can get rid of players like Wilson Chandler, get something back in return. They have a lot of young core, and I don't know what they're going to do with Faried, but I think they should have made the playoffs.
Do you think Denver would have been a better matchup for Houston?
I think they would have been a better matchup because Wolves is too young still. They're not deep, whereas Denver, they have the kind of players that can really keep up against Chris Paul and James Harden. So they have players like Jamal Murray and Gary Harris who are pretty good defenders. I think Jokic will be a matchup nightmare against Capella. And they're a bit deeper teams because Paul Millsap could have had a better... he could keep up more with three-pointers like Ryan Anderson or Gerald Green and PJ Tucker, Trevor Ariza. So I think they would have been a better matchup than the Wolves.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's move on to the next team. Detroit Pistons. What are your two cents about the Detroit Pistons? Were they too late?
It was a good move for them because they weren't going really anywhere with the kind of squad that they had. So it was a good move for them to acquire Blake Griffin. And the fact that they went all out on him to get him. Not all out, but I mean, they spent quite a lot of money and the players that they gave up to get him. This was their goal to see if they can make Detroit Pistons a bit more marketable and a bit more attractive to fans because they were going in a new arena. It's just that they need a bit more pieces, and then injuries too kind of affected them with Reggie Jackson. I think they were disappointing this year. They should have been better than what they are.
There was like a flash of brilliance
Blake Griffin.
he kind of showed out for a couple of games, but then it slowly fizzled out. So the spark was there. I just don't know, For me, I don't know if they really can be a playoff contender team. It's like a last minute type of, trying to put the pieces together.
They need some personal change with their guard position because they're still very, very short. Not very short, but their depth is not as... they need someone with three-point shooting, first of all, with defense on their perimeter. They have a bunch of players that are not really well-known. And they need someone that can play both ends of the floor at least, because Blake could facilitate for them. So if they find guards that can shoot and defend, that would really help them because Blake could be a facilitator because he's a really good passer. And they didn't have that. So Blake and Andre Drummond was taking over and really carrying the whole Pistons team. But their 3-2 guards, nobody really knew them. Reggie Jackson was injured and Ishmael was good, but he's more of a ball dominant point guard. and that's not really how that's what he had with Chris Paul, and it didn't really work so well for them. So for Detroit Pistons, I think they're going to need a season to really figure it out together, and maybe next year I expect them to be better.
So that's a definite no, they shouldn't have made the playoffs.
No, because they weren't ready. They didn't have the personnel, and they just went all out to get Griffin.
Yeah.
I think this summer was their plan to get the current right kind of players to surround Blake Griffin and Andre Drummond. So I hope that they, once offseason starts, they do make the right personnel moves.
Good segue from Blake Griffin, where he came from, LA Clippers. Mm. Should they have made the playoffs?
For them, it was injuries. I mean, they were close. They were, everybody, I mean, even Charles Barkley said that they were going to make the Western Conference final. That's how good they were when Blake Griffin was gone. So, and they have the right type of players to surround the team. And it's just injuries really killed them this year. Mm. I mean,
I think that was the basic theme for the whole NBA.
The whole season was just injuries. But they were one of the biggest ones because they lost their starting point guard. They lost Patrick Beverley. They lost Milos Teodosic. They lost Danilo Gallinari. So they had a lot of injuries. And that's their starting for a guard, point guard, shooting guard, and small forward. And Tobias Harris has been so good for them. Like, he seems like he's the kind of player that anywhere you trade him, he just plays well. Because the moment he was traded from Orlando to Detroit, he was playing well. From Detroit to the Lakers, he was just, you know, a 20-point scorer per game. So he was a good stretch four for them. And then DeAndre, which is being DeAndre. And Lou Williams just blossomed for them and carried them to all. But imagine that, having Patrick Beverley and Milos as their, you know, both off guards. Danilo, you have Milos and Harris, and then DeAndre Jordan. And then you have a really good bench for them because they have, what, Marjanovic, Boban is playing off the bench for them. And then you're going to have Lou Williams coming off the bench. So that's a pretty good, decent team. They're not going to go as far, like, anywhere. But then, like, they were really close to making the playoffs. I think if they had the players that were injured, they could have made the playoffs.
Mm-hmm. So I guess the only strong one was Denver. But injuries are injuries. Detroit, no, you're not ready. But so the playoffs turned out as you expected, though, like the ones that deserved it.
Mm-hmm. The one that deserved it, made it. Yeah.
Especially the Butler situation. Jimmy Butler came back at the right time to take
they
his
earned,
team.
They earned. Yeah. They wanted it more, I believe, at the end. Mm-hmm. As much as I wanted Denver, because they were a better matchup than Houston, Timberwolves just wanted it more. I mean, Cat went off, but Jimmy Butler just wanted it. I mean, that's where experience comes in, right? You're going to have Coach Thibodeau right there with experience in playoffs, and you're gonna have Jimmy Butler, who's been there, done that. Derrick Rose was there, so you have veteran players that knew how to kind of make it. And Denver really don't have that type of veteran leadership that Timberwolves had, and that's just how they won it. So.
When we come back, we're gonna talk about what teams impressed us the most, and also about the series going on. What do we expect, and what our predictions are when we return.